Hi, in this how video of the accounting procedure section, I'm pleased to show you how to assess the purchase to pay process. The purpose of the activity is to assess if the procedure in place and the control implemented related to operating cost and account payable stream are effective to mitigate the associated risk of material misstatement in the financial statement. What is important when we perform the assessment of the accounting procedures in general is to have in your mind to focus on the information in the financial statement. Then you go backward to understand all the flow of the information, the processes and the control that can mitigate the risk of material misstatement in the financial statement figures or disclosure. The activities that has to be performed during the accounting procedures assessment are generally three main activities that are first, you have to detect the procedure. And this activity is performed generally during preliminary. Then second point is to assess the design of the process and the control of the process. And this activity is performed as well in preliminary. Then you have a third point, to test the implementation and effectiveness of the controls in place. And these activities is performed generally during preliminary, but also during final phase. This because you have to cover the full period of the audit to make sure that the control are implemented during the whole period. For a deeper understanding of the procedures and control testing, please refer to our video 412 of the accounting procedure section. Now, let's see the key points that we will focus on the purchase to pay accounting process video. First, we will see the flowchart related to the purchase to pay process. Therefore, we will begin from the financial statement. We will see the account balances and classes of transaction that are related to the purchase to pay, and all the flow of information that are coming from the order to the material processes to the invoicing and payable. Then we will focus on each process that is important on the purchase to pay, that are the supplier database to understand how it's set in the ERP and which kind of control are required. Then all the order or contract management from the insertion of the data to the check of the data. And then how is performed the activity and of the price list management. Then we will move to understand the flow of information and how the material receipt and stock information has to be understood. Then we will check how to assess the invoicing process, the payment flow, and finally, how the payables management has to be understood. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this video. To view the full video of other audit topics, request the video by mail. PDF slides are also available. Otherwise, find the video online on the most common e-learning platform as Udemy, Skillshare, and many more soon. For our video on Audit Insight and all video preview, visit us in YouTube, Facebook, or LinkedIn, and subscribe for to be updated on any new content. If you prefer private classes for learning, to have a teacher completely dedicated to teach you audit topics at your own speed and answer all your questions, book our private classes that can be held online or on-site. For detail and to book your private class, contact us by mail. Audit Advisory Service help you with any project related to audit, as accounting procedure, estimate, financial adjustment, and other audit-related activities. Outsourcing of audit activity service gives you the opportunity to have an expert taking care of your audit work, while you can dedicate your time to more important tasks. Whatever choice you make after the video, just remember to focus, learn, and do it.